Hello everyone, this is iPurge People. I'm going to be doing a new Let's Play series on this here game, Spellbinder. It's a little indie RPG created by someone called Original Widge, I guess. It's made on the RPG Maker VX platform. Like it says here, copyright 2011, it's a newer game. I've played it a bit. I beat the first boss, and it was quite well done. Honestly, the first boss is quite difficult if you're not ready for it. I died the first time I fought her. Unfortunately, I got her down to about 600 health, and then she managed to crit me and one-shot me. But yeah, so let me go ahead and if my FPS would get above, you know, 1/2, I might be able to actually start up a new file here, and we can start this Let's Play. There we go, much better. However, I don't know why it's so laggy. But I'm gonna go ahead and fiddle with some settings on my computer and see if that helps. Alright, I'm back, and looks like this is working much better. So, I'm gonna go on ahead and continue now. Usually helps if I don't accidentally turn off the recording. Alright, like I said, I'm gonna go ahead and continue. There's an epic opening cinematic, so I'm gonna go ahead and shut up and let that play for you. Enjoy. I apologize for the frame rate drop. It's going to mess up the timing of the song, but it'll just start over again in a loop. So, yeah. It'll be fine. See, now is usually when the cinematic ends. Alright, and that was the intro cinematic, and as it said, it says 87 years later, this old woman here is going to go ahead and tell the story of the Spellbinders. Yeah, again, I do apologize for the frame rate. My computer is not liking fraps right now. I don't have any idea what I can do to stop it, you know, from crapping out like this, but in the meantime, go ahead and start going through this text here. If I'm going too fast for you, go ahead and just pause the video. You won't hurt my feelings. I think they said that already, but okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and stick with the, you know, what they gave us. So I'll go ahead and just go with it. So Sadoth, I guess, would be how you pronounce that. Anyway, ignore the A equals accept. That's some kind of like controller thing, I guess. Like if you plug in a controller. By A on the keyboard, it would be Z for me. It took me forever to get used to, like with shops and stuff, and I was trying to learn how to play this game. Yeah, I forgot to mention that. This is actually, it has a little bit of, you know, profanity and stuff in it. Some people might not find it to be for them, but yeah, I mean, if you don't have any problem with, you know, some swearing and some, you know, anyway, go ahead and play the game. Midi Luna Wire, I don't know, I just call it MIDI for short. I don't really try to pronounce the town. It's a little too long. The frame rate's gone down again. So, let's see here. If I can remember what all is in this house. That right there, that icon, is money. That's a potion. I just got four of them. And that's a reference pamphlet, which will teach you how to play the game. Look at this. The city doesn't even know what it is. It's in a chest inside of his own house. No, but seriously. You know, just like in a lot of old RPGs, you can walk over to the bed and you can rest, you know, free of charge. I thought there was something else in the house. Guess I was misremembering. Alright, Yep, and here we encounter our first save icon. See, now up there it says Z equals skip. However, if I hit Z... It's actually just gonna continue on with the tutorial. So, yeah, saving is not required. However, I generally tend to obey their saving signals. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and save now so that I can create my other file. And, yeah. Because I've got another file. Yeah, see, that's my main file there. Level 9. Not going to go too much into what that symbol means or anything like that. But you'll see I've got about 3 hours total playtime. That's, you know, including me running around, learning the game, and just searching, like, everything. Like, completely searching everything. Because that's, you know, what I do in games like this. I would run around town, like, for instance, here, and I would just, like, look at everything and click it. And, yeah. I'm not going to do that in here for you guys, you know, for your sake. Because, first of all, I am going to... No, wait. I don't want to go up there. A cool thing about this game is that in the thicker grass, you do move slower. So, it's definitely something to keep in mind. These little people walking around, they just say silly things. Great day for a walk, and he's on lap 6. His laps go up constantly throughout the game. You'll notice up here, or you may notice anyway, hopefully you notice, there's a chest here. And in this chest is a scorpion, which is a nice little sword that is a huge upgrade. You can get right at the beginning. I actually did the first dungeon without the scorpion, got a better weapon, and found the scorpion, and realized, oh crap, I could have made that a lot easier on myself if I'd have seen that chest. So, let me here talk to some people here. She wants some tea, apparently. But, sadly, she's all out, so... Now, up till now, I still had absolutely no idea where this park is. So... As soon as I find out, I'll go ahead and do it. It says Northland Trail Park. I just don't know where that is, unfortunately, so... He is working on something for Orlix. Orlix is a huge character here at the beginning, so... WM... They explain it later on, what WM means. I can't even remember what it is off the top of my head to tell you guys, but they do explain it later on, after you know, deal with the WM Tower. Go figure, right? Thank you. 7 pots, 3 pyromites. Pyromites are a class of items. They're like little usable items that like deal damage to enemies and such. See, the ESRB would rate this tea for teen for, you know, mild language and alcohol reference. And yes, you'll notice that says Earth Shrine. That's just how they shorthand elements in this. Like light is L apostrophe YT, I believe, or LY apostrophe T, something like that. Yeah, Earth is E apostrophe RF. So. Let's talk to her. Alex is looking for me. And you'll see this little arrow in front of this door. That means that there's some story update in this building. So this is actually where I need to go. And there's Orlix. Before I talk to Orlix, however, let me show you something that I very, very much like about this game. Because when I come over here to the piano... Oh, what? Okay. It worked in my other file. Hang on. Okay, it's not gonna work right now. Whatever. Maybe it'll work after I talk to him. He's a bit of a smart-mouthed brat at the moment. Your normal, you know, teacher stuff. Oh, maybe he does know something after. Because that sounds simple, you know. Third level constriction spell is apparently quite simple. Wasn't he all smart mouth just a minute ago? Yeah, see? He thinks so too. Resourceful old geezer. Yeah, see, fire and water. Fire and water, I guess. Thank you. Sorry about that on the last, near the end of that dialogue there. My finger slipped off the button and it wouldn't continue on. Alright, let's start the piano now. Huh. Just, for some odd reason, it's just not going to work right now. I'll try again later. Basically, it plays another little song, and I very much like the little song that it plays. And I have absolutely no idea what that is. It sounds like an advertisement from Chrome. I'll be right back. I'm gonna go ahead and shut that down wherever it is. All right, and we are back. Apparently, my Fraps filming button opens up the inventory as well. So that's what that was all about. So, first of all, I'm going to come in here to the shop. Alright, since I have 42 money. Oh, that's right. Never mind. I'm not going to do that. Somewhere along the line, in my other file, I ended up with a bunch of money, and I don't remember how I got it. I'll try coming over here. No, oh, that's right. There was a reason I wanted to come in here to begin with, because that gave me a jeweled necklace. And I can look at this thing. And yet, I have absolutely no idea how to get the key. So, if anyone knows how to get the key, please go ahead and leave a comment. Is it after? You know, is it, like, later on in the game? Because, like I said, my other file is... I'm only level 9 in it. So, I haven't gotten too far. I've done a couple dungeons, and that's about it, so... Let's go on through here, and you'll notice that little red arrow. Basically what that means is you can see here up on the top left, that right there is basically like some kind of like a threat meter sort of deal. Basically when that turns, it progresses as time goes on. Yeah, see, here's the HUD for it. Forgot there was a HUD for it. A tutorial for the HUD. As I'm sitting here explaining it. Shifts from green to red. Battle is imminent. Not necessarily. And it's color-coded. If it's a red box, that means you definitely don't want to be there. And I've noticed it's yellow. Yellow to the greenish yellow is like... you know, just above level or, you know, at level, and then it's only green if it's below level, so. Run over here real quick. Oh, no, wait, I don't want to do that. I went the wrong way. Silly me. Anyway, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to run over here, and the first couple battles you do are quite difficult. See, now it's red. Let's do the auto plus tutorial. And yet, I'm sure there's going to be plenty of people who don't know what a macro is, so... I don't even know what macros are used for in this game. I haven't gotten them yet. I'm assuming it's once you get more party members. The Auto Plus thing is nice, but it's nice, but once you get a good inventory of spells, it just likes to start using spells and sap away your MP like mad, and I just don't like it very much at that point. See, look at that. I just crit for 666. I mean, come on. This is some, like, evil spirit-possessed guy. And he's sitting here critting for 666 right out the bat. Or right off the bat, rather. I mean, come on. How suggestive can you get? Something that's not actually extremely, self-explanatory. I'm gonna go ahead and, well, first of all, I have a couple of abilities here. I'm not gonna use them because I don't need to. Is the defend option. What this does is it gives you HP and MP, as well as defends you and, like, reduces the damage you take by, I think, 40%. It's not quite half. So, you saw, you know, that, heals me up a bit. I didn't know about that until, until right before I fought the first boss in the second dungeon. So, these, first couple battles were quite difficult for me, because I didn't have any way to heal myself other than, you know, using potions. I'm gonna go ahead and, go through this quickly here. You'll see how, you know, with two of these mobs, it's not really doing too much. So, in order to really, use it effectively, you want to diminish the numbers as best you can. If you're trying to heal yourself with it, that is. If you're just trying to get MP, you know, it's not as big of a deal to lower it, you know, if you're not too worried about the health. Especially later in the game when you get a certain ability that basically makes all attacks against you nullify. It's quite a nifty little ability. See, now I'm like fully healed more or less, so I can go ahead and finish it off. Oh, I didn't crit for 666 that time. In fact, I'm personally finding the music to be a little loud, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn that down real quick. Or not, because apparently I can't do that. I thought I could, but apparently I couldn't, so never mind. Anyway, just so that, yeah, so now, alright, I'm hitting up, and that goes to auto plus, and now it goes back to auto. I'll go ahead and use the auto plus for this fight, just so you guys can see how it works. I just used the ability Borealis, which is a waste of mana, and I just used it again. More wasted mana. At this point, mana isn't really a big concern for me. MP, rather. I'm an MMO player. I call it mana. Leave me alone. There's surprise attacks and preemptive strikes in this game, much like in Chrono Trigger, if anyone's ever played Chrono Trigger. Unlike Chrono Trigger, however, obviously the mobs aren't on the map, so you can't just, you know, avoid them. So, see, you'll see that it's saying I'm getting 2 MP. However, if you look at the HP bar, it is actually healing me, you know, health-wise as well. So, I'll defend one more time. You may be wondering why I'm, there we go, I leveled up. You may be wondering why I'm choosing to defend instead of just using potions or something. In order to heal myself, since I have so many potions at the beginning. The first boss is hard enough to the point to where I started her with 20 potions, give or take, I think, in my main file, and at the end I had like 3 left. So I'm going to try and save them up as much as I can here, so I can go to MIDI to the left, go to WM Tower up top, and Trail East to the right. Well, I don't want to go to Trail East, I want to go to the tower, so... I absolutely love the victory music, I might add. Here we go. Spellbinding tutorial. Like the bot. Like those green things I was just killing. Bind is a nice little skill. It does damage. You're at level 1. I've only ever seen it do a preemptive strike. That means I get to attack first. I've only ever seen Bind do 40 damage. However, the actual Bind itself, 33% success rate for it to steal an ability. I'm gonna go ahead and steal from the Lupin because it has the most useful skill I have found yet in the game. Unfortunately, that stupid bug hurts a lot. And there it goes. Attack down curse. Hands down my favorite spell that I've found yet in the game. If I recall correctly, that's the only ability the Lupin has. So I'm gonna kill it, and, although I doubt you could hear me because of the thunder sound, I went ahead and killed it. I'll go ahead and heal up because, yeah, that bolt of it, the, bug just does way too much damage. May as well test out my new skill and curse the bug. Oh, it missed. If it would have hit, you'd be seeing it under the health bar of the enemy. Ow, that hurt. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and heal. And I've got two more shots to steal something from it. It's got two abilities, the two that you've seen. Well. See, you'll notice how it says failed there. I can steal abilities from them if I kill them. At least I'm assuming as much, I've never actually had it happen yet. So that was a rather unlucky fight. Sometimes that happens, sometimes, you know, actually able to get stuff from it. But, that's basically how you, gain skills in this. You don't necessarily have to do it like I did, but, I try and get them all out of the way as soon as I possibly can. Alright, since I know that little green thing doesn't have anything, that Osens or Osens, however you pronounce it, doesn't have any abilities for me, go ahead and kill it. So if you guys are playing this game, don't waste your time on binding from the Osens. It doesn't do anything but 40 damage. Now, I am going to go ahead and try stealing from this Lupid, just in case he does have another ability. I don't think he does, though. We'll find out. In fact, just to make sure that he can't kill me. See, you can see the attack down icon underneath the name. See, he does one damage to me. Like I said, pretty much nullifies attack. Sometimes it actually does nullify attacks and then you do zero damage. That'll happen once I get a little bit higher up in levels. Alright, yeah. That right there means that he doesn't have any other abilities. So in the meanwhile, I'm gonna go ahead and kill this thing off. And I just remembered that I have a weapon to equip that I forgot to equip, so I'm gonna go ahead and equip that as well. Here after this battle. Victory scene, rather. Since I forgot to equip it. And it has wind property and poison property on there. That's what those icons up there mean. A sword with a spiked blade, and then it's got wind element and poison element. Like I said, I never actually used the scorpion in my first file. So I don't actually know how it works exactly, but we'll find out eventually. Oh, save icon, which means I'm going to go ahead and save as soon as I come up here to this chest. And get some Sundaw extract, which is basically some kind of antidote thing you saw in the shop. And that's why it's called WM Tower, Wurlick Mibbleschwip. This guy's got an imagination when it comes to names, I tell you what. Alright, so let's see what happens. Alright, so let's go ahead and walk in here since the blue arrow means that there's no enemies. Let's go ahead and in here. Actually, if you look over here, there's some spikes on the ground here. Basically means I can't actually go through here. So, the only thing I can really do on this side here is open this chest. which gives me some Thunderium, which is nice to have. Alright, see, this says it's level 5. I'm currently level 2. When I did this on my first game, I was level 4 by the time I walked into this tower. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grind my way up in the area I was just in before to level 4. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and do that, and hopefully, you know, time pending, also get into the tower and at least start it. That'll be the next video, because this video here is running a little long, about 25 minutes or so. So, in the meantime, this is Purge signing out. Also, before I do, Spellbinder, I'll put a link in the description. So you can download it. You will need the RPG Maker VX Runtime Package, also known as the RTP. I don't recall if it comes with the download or not. If it does not, I will go ahead and link to it specifically as well. But yeah, definitely check this game out if you're if you like RPGs. It's quite fun. Now, Purge signing out.